Hello, everyone. This is the Lithuanian diaspora media channel, Pilietybe.lt, and I'm Rimvydas Baltaduonis, joining today from Gettysburgh College in Pennsylvania, the United States of America. Today we decided to invite guests to introduce us about a global initiative to support Ukrainian students, Ukrainian scholars. With me today, I have two guests. I have Oleksandr Akymenko. He is a lecturer at Lviv Business School of Ukrainian Catholic University, co-founder of Stanford's Ukrainian Emerging Leaders Program, and played a part of the founding team of the Ukrainian Global University. Hello, Oleksandr.
Hello, thank you for having me.
And then joining us, Andrii Smytsniuk. He's a senior teaching associate at the University of Cambridge, co-founder of the volunteer initiative Cambridge for Ukraine, and a coordinator of the team of representatives of the Ukrainian Global University in the United Kingdom. Hello, Andrii.
Hello, Rim. Thank you for having us here, and thank you for all the viewers joining.
Andrii, you are joining us from UK, right?
Yes, that is correct.
So I have to be, I have to give a shout out to one of my students, Aidan Wisniewski-Kampo, who connected us. If it wouldn't be for his efforts and his initiative, three of us would have never spoken together. And he reached out to you, Andrii, probably as a representative of the Ukrainian Global University. Do you get a lot of calls like that and people reaching out to you?
Absolutely. So my job within the Ukrainian Global University is reach out to universities, primarily in the UK, but elsewhere, but also contact them once they submitted some of the requests. And for the moment, we have close to 50 partner universities that are on the list of our partners all across the world that provided a few hundred different opportunities for the students, both graduate, undergraduate, summer courses, fellowships, etc. So I would say that support for Ukraine is very, very strong. But this is also the very beginning. We have a lot more requests that we are working at this very moment than requests that we already took to the partnership stage. I would say that universities all across the world are applying, are trying to show their interest with Ukrainian Global University. And Ukrainian Global University can assist them with finding the Ukrainian students for their opportunities.
So, Oleksandr, you were one of the founding team members for the Ukrainian Global University. Could you tell us what is it? What's the concept and how does it work?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is the initiative of several organizations, including academic institutions, Ukrainian academic institutions, and also NGOs, which gather together to create the initiative or a network of universities all around the world to assist, to help, to host Ukrainian students, researchers, and help them to continue their education in different countries, and then at the very end to return them to Ukraine and help to rebuild it after these devastating consequences of war. So we gathered together, and literally most of our team were doing this project from bomb shelters, we just decided that. We've noticed that so many universities want to help, and they started to announce the fellowships or the programs for Ukrainian students or scholars. And we decided just to accumulate all of this information in one resource, first of all. And secondly, not only this, but also build trustworthy relationship with these institutions to have this partnership last not only during the attention to Ukraine is attracted by this catastrophic events which is happening right now, but also in a year, in two, in the future, because we need this integration to world best educational system for many years. You know, we just on the beginning of this way, and the percentage of Ukrainian students who is studying abroad is very low comparably with different other countries. So we actually contacted the office of the president of Ukraine, Zelensky, and also the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and they gladly endorsed this initiative. And this was actually created with their assistant help and endorsement. So we have this as partners, and we are proud to have governmental institutions which support such kind of initiatives. And also, as Andrii told, we have already more than 50 or around 50 universities or around the world from different continents who decided to actually to help or to donate their resources to Ukrainian students, because as you know, education is not cheap in some countries especially, and we are super grateful for these institutions for this amazing help, and we want to be sure that these students will be studying at the very edge of their talent and opportunities, and will come back to Ukraine afterwards.
Oleksandr, I'm looking at the list of the schools, universities, and colleges that have already signed up for partnership with the Ukrainian Global University. Can you mention some of them?
Yes, it's University of Toronto, it's Penn State, it's New York University, LCC University from Lithuania, which we are really proud of. They announced a program for 100 Ukrainian students, which is just amazing. And part of them is provided by a Ukrainian Global University initiative. And also some universities, it's actually, we are right now, there are a lot, some, let's say, maybe around 80 universities in the pipeline. So who just came to our website and applied to provide some assistance or places or summer programs or online courses to Ukrainian students. And we are now on the way of negotiating and talking to them and formalizing this cooperation with our document, which we call like memorandum of understanding with these universities to understand how many places we have. And also from another side, we have this process of selecting Ukrainian students. We have this one window where they just apply, and this is a just simple questionnaire of what motivation do they have, what English proficiency level do they have, or other language. And and we just gather this information and then match these students between, like match students with universities and also scientists with universities. And I forgot to tell that we are helping not only just regular students, I mean, bachelor or master students. It's starting from the boarding school. So we have some boarding schools who are ready to take schoolers, actually, then bachelor's, master programs, PhD and postdoc program. So we're actually receiving a lot of assistance from any of these degrees provided, and we're happy to any help of the university which can provide.
So Andrii, do I understand this correctly? This works basically like a almost dating site for students in Ukraine and universities, academic institutions abroad. Your initiative allows to do the matching while staying connected with the students who pursue international education.
Yes, absolutely. So in a way, it works as a matching platform. And it solves some of the problems for universities outside of so international universities, because for those international universities, for example, universities in Lithuania or United Kingdom or United States, they are sometimes willing to offer some opportunities to Ukrainian students. The problem is that for some Ukrainian students now in the time of war, when sometimes they don't necessarily have stable access to the internet, when sometimes they don't know of opportunities that are existent in other countries, they might not be able to find those opportunities, those specific opportunities, for example, in Lithuania or in the United States. However, what we try to do is to match the university and students. So in a way, we do all that looking, all that searching and browsing work for the student. But also we do the, we provide, we offer some students to universities that they would like to take. So one of the problems that we solve that often comes up, for example, in the United Kingdom, is that they are always afraid if the students will have a level of English proficiency enough to study at the university. And what we do is we conduct a process that we call pre-admissions, where we, in a way, we make sure that their English proficiency is high enough to participate in learning process in higher education institution, or at least higher, at least a boarding school in outside of Ukraine. And we do some pre-admissions, we do some basic interviews with them to make sure that they do have at least some very basic knowledge in that discipline, that they will be a good candidate for the university. And then we create a list of potential students that the university could be interested in, and we transfer it to the university, and then university conducts their normal admissions activities.
So from what I hear, you are using this platform from the boarding school through students who are undergraduates, graduates, even scholars. What kind of opportunities are you looking from universities all over the world to be offered to these students, to these scholars, to these academic members? Oleksandr, maybe you could summarize for us.
Yeah, so just frankly speaking, we are not in a position to demand anything from these universities. We are really answering this question because a lot of universities and academic institutions are asking themselves, how might we help? So Ukrainian Global University is part of this answer. How might they help to provide these scholarships for like tuition waivers or like accommodation or different formats of education? We obviously want to prioritize the full degree programs fully covered by the university. This is the, you know, like the top of the top, which any university can provide. And country by country, the system differs. Some countries have absolutely free, tuition-free education. Some countries have the opposite, extremely expensive education, like the United States of America, as you know. And, you know, like different countries can provide different things. But we are grateful for any help of any university. For example, like just recently, we had amazing collaboration, which not ended yet, but this is a Berkeley Law School executive education program. They came to us and told, like, we have 100 free certificates for our finance fundamental course for lawyers. So if there are 100 lawyers in Ukraine who is ready to take this course for free from Berkeley with a certificate. And so we found these 100 lawyers. We've made this announcement public, and they came and they will receive this link to this course, and they will, you know, this is not full degree, this is not master degree or something else, but anyway, we are really, really grateful and happy to any help that educational institutions are now providing. We obviously want to prioritize the full degrees, but we understand how complicated sometimes it is for institutions to provide that.
So the support is could be in any way from academic community to engage with Ukrainian students, scholars, universities in Ukraine. Andrii, how many students do you think would be interested, or what's the pool of students that potentially could seek this aid from global academic community?
I would need to look at specific numbers, but we're hoping to send at least 1,000 students at the moment. But we envision this initiative as a long-term initiative. Firstly, because we're not sure when exactly the war will end, and although we are hoping for a quick solution, it's unlikely to happen very soon. And secondly, we also need to rebuild Ukraine. Yeah, if you go to the website, the main goal here is to rebuild Ukraine. And we see that for this process of rebuilding Ukraine, we need the people who are, first of all, very well educated, and then secondly, alive. This is also very important. So this is the reason why we try to ensure some scholarships for Ukrainian students or scholars outside of Ukraine in safety. So when the war is over, they could come back to Ukraine and contribute to its development. So I would say that we would like to continue this program for years to come. And we intend to send more students, but I think that this year our main goal would be to send at least to ensure safety of at least one student / scholars.
Mm-hmm. So this is an initiative looking into the future. This is an opportunity for global academic community to join the efforts to rebuild Ukraine, starting even now, right? And we have a unique chance to do that in a way that's thoughtful, that's professional, that raises the level of expertise of Ukrainians to do that as soon as they're able to do that. So given that, Oleksandr, can you tell us what are the steps that universities and colleges and schools should take if they would be interested in getting engaged with this initiative, the Global Ukrainian University?
So first of all, on our website, uglobal.university, the university have to go to the section for educational institutions and see the example of memorandum of understanding. And mark what the institution is ready to provide, and then contact any one of us, maybe a coordinator in the country which university is located in, or maybe part of our executive team, literally everyone, anyone, and we can talk and also understand how many places is this. What are the mains that the university is ready to provide the education in, and also we will look to our database of interviewed students, and then we will do a matching process and suggest a list of students to the university to select from. And the university can obviously do their regular, or we ask for simplified admission process, because we're doing this pre-admission step, and then invite students to campus.
The initiatives or interest from students to go abroad is actually quite common these days, right? The current situation is where people migrate a lot, they seek opportunities. And one of the concerns that many countries face is the brain drain, including Lithuania, where many initiatives sort of have a hard time tracking people that migrate throughout the world. Andrii, do you have a plan how to maybe prevent the brain drain? So all those Ukrainian students that do go study abroad, that they would be contributing to the mission to rebuild Ukraine in the future.
Absolutely. And I think that this is very one of those byproducts of war, which is very, very unfortunate. But obviously, the problem was existent before before the war and before escalation of the war in February 2022. And for that, we envision different mechanisms that would encourage the students who join some university outside of Ukraine through Ukrainian Global University to then come back to Ukraine. For example, there is we envision a number of programs that would engage with the students and bring them to internships in Ukraine, and where they will have an ability and an opportunity to put their knowledge to the test. And I think that will be a very interesting test, as it would require some work to rebuilding an entire country. So another thing that we are trying to do to make sure that these students will one day come back is actually create some sense of a community, yeah, a global university, yeah, a global community of scholars, each one of whom will apply through Ukrainian Global University, and we will try to make sure that they stay in contact, they have a possibility of discussing future possibilities, future ideas that they can further implement in Ukraine. So community and also engagement, I think, are two main instruments. And of course, there are a number of organizations that are part of Ukrainian Global University Network that try to engage the students. For example, the initiative I'm a part of, which is called Professional Government Association of Ukraine, which is an association which actually unites those in Ukraine who did their studies some were in outside of Ukraine, so in some Western universities or Eastern universities that received some good education abroad and are willing to implement this education in creating better Ukraine, so to say. And we envision internship programs or even employment opportunities for those all who want to come and work in Ukraine, not even necessarily the students that went through Ukrainian Global Universities, but students from all across the world that would like to contribute to this process afterwards, that would like to, you know, join rebuilding Ukraine, even if they did not receive any education through Ukrainian Global University. And with this all being said, I think we all understand that a number of the students think might not return. So a number of students might, go elsewhere or come back to Ukraine and then return back to the country where they complete their studies. But we see that no matter the point, no matter the geographical location, they all will be able to contribute to growth of Ukraine. So, for example, you can see Oleksandr.
So you have a plan even after the studies to continue engaging these students, scholars, already have links to the internship programs in Ukraine, and that could be the next step, sort of logical step, engaging them in rebuilding Ukraine. I listen to you, and I'm a little bit jealous because even Lithuania, with all its efforts to engage diaspora, still does not have a platform where it could unite all the students that are studying in different universities all over the world to keep that community tight. So this is a good example, probably not just to Lithuania, but other countries that experience many students leaving the countries to pursue education, global education. Speaking of Lithuania, so you mentioned LCC International University, which is based in Klaipeda. They already have a memorandum of understanding with you. Are there other Lithuanian universities that you are talking to?
We are now not talking to any other Lithuanian universities, but we are happy to. And by the way, talking about the diaspora and the way to let's say to somehow follow this model, this can be done pretty easily. As Yurim mentioned, there are a lot of Lithuanians who are traveling all around the world and they are studying or working there. These are all your protagonists, you know, your partners in achieving this goal. So what we've done, we've opened on our website two sections, three sections. One is for universities who wants to help us. Second, it's for volunteers. It's mostly Ukrainian students or alumni of Western universities with Ukrainian origin, or just foreign professors or students who want to help us to convince universities. And right now we have around 350 volunteers in more than 35 countries of the world who is actually right now connected in these chats according to the country they want to help with, and they are talking to universities on behalf of Ukrainian Global University. So it's a global network of activists, academic activists, let's say, who are helping us to negotiate and to convince this university. So you can follow this model too, because you have a lot of people who are abroad, who have amazing experience and who are alumni of different institutions to do that.
So I would like to use this opportunity and to speak now to my fellows from Lithuania and global Lithuanians that are pursuing their dreams all over the world. If you are a student, a faculty member, an administrator, and work at university or college or school, reach out to your administrators of the school and encourage them to check out the website of the Ukrainian Global University. So you could pursue potentially some collaborations. This is our joint effort to build and rebuild Ukraine that is free, democratic, and prosperous. We are having this conversation 3 months after the invasion of Ukraine and war of Ukraine. Invasion happened a long time ago, 2014, but the war that has been happening for 3 months that was so brutal and destroyed the cities did not destroy the spirit of Ukrainians. And we need to be together, Lithuanians, Latvians, Estonians, Polish, Europeans throughout the world. I call you to listen to the call from our colleagues in Ukraine to join us in the efforts to combine our forces and educate the future of Ukraine, so they would be ready to rebuild faster, as fast as possible. As we close this, I would like to give the last word to two of you. Maybe you have a call to your fellows as well. So use this opportunity to do that. So, Oleksandr.
Thank you, Rim, first of all, for organizing that. And I would like to ask any person who is somehow connected to academic institution to support Ukrainian students if they are studying right now, or if you want them on campus, it would be amazing, amazing help. And we already feel this help here in Ukraine, and you actually give people hope
for the better future. And this is one of the missions of academic institutions all around the world. And we have to be connected and build a model for any other country which will get into this unfortunate circumstances that we have right now in Ukraine. And I think all people from other countries with conflict deserves this as well. Thank you very much for your support. We're feeling that and we're grateful.
And Andrei?
I also want to say that we do greatly support, we do greatly appreciate all kinds of support, but specifically from Lithuania. I think we are all grateful for the political support, for financial support. I personally very much enjoyed watching the Monica Lewis cover song of Kalush from Eurovision. I like it more than the original, so I do greatly appreciate support on all levels. And we do greatly appreciate support from LCC International University in Klaipeda. And we're just hoping that more of the people present here could potentially reach to their universities or their colleagues in other universities and encourage them to join. I think it's fair to say that University of Lithuania can offer educational opportunities to Ukrainians in any way possible. What we can do is to promote those among the Ukrainian students with the help of a presidential office and Ministry of Education and Science of Ukraine, and make sure that you get the best of Ukrainian students. So thank you very much, and I hope we'll hear from you at some point.
Wonderful, and I hope more Lithuanian universities will jump on this opportunity to have Ukrainian scholars, Ukrainian students, study at those institutions, work at those institutions, and gain more experience, more expertise. This was the Lithuanian Diaspora Channel, Pilietybe.lt. You can see this interview, this conversation on our social media channels as well. It's on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. Pilietybe.lt is our website. Please visit, share, and let's stay together. Let's be creative. Let's be supportive of each other. Today, we had Oleksandr Akymenko joining us from Ukraine, and Andrii Smytsniuk from the United Kingdom. Thank you very much for joining us. Until next time.
Thank you, Rim.